is legend.
I love it. I love the fact that Ric Flair gets a chance to take out Jerry the King Lawler. And you haven't even thanked me for joining you to fill in for the King so he can face the Nature Boy.
Thanks.
The following is a Legends match, and it is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, from Charlotte, North Carolina, the Nature Boy, Ric Flair.
A 16-time former heavyweight champion of the world is best made by acting general manager Randy Orton, the Legend Killer, putting two legends together on the King's birthday.
That is the only thing that I like that Randy Orton has done here tonight. That's the only thing in this match.
Wait, he let you enter the Battle Royal.
Well, that was fun, but I didn't win, so now I don't like the Battle Royal. What can you do? Well, tonight, WWE Raw is being brought to you by Wrangler. Makers of Wrangler Jeans Company, a new generation of Wrangler.
And by WWE SmackDown versus Raw. Two worlds collide on PlayStation 2.
And by Yu Hakusho. Check this out. I love this guy. You gotta watch this.
Jerry the King Lawler!
Everybody deserves to have a happy birthday. Everybody does.
Exactly. King's birthday here today. Former AWA champion. And hey, you heard about the Tonight Show tomorrow night?
Well, I heard that the remaining couple of contestants ran into Chris and Kim from the Tonight Show. And you can see that tomorrow night.
Of course, Chris and Kim are the hairstylists of the Tonight Show. And check your local listings for the Tonight Show tomorrow night.
Yeah, of course, hosted by Jay Leno. Huge show. Check your local listings.
Well, here we go, and you know, a lot of folks don't know that the new fans, certainly that Jerry the Lawler was a former world-class champion. He was a former AWA champion.
And who would ever think that we'd ever see this match? Did you ever think 2004 we'd see Ric Flair and Jerry the King? When we came in this building tonight, did you think we would see this match?
Absolutely not, and I'll tell you something. Oh, look at this.
And did you ever think that you'd be able to call this match of legends with the one and only coach? You probably never thought that either.
I'm just, hey, it's my lucky day.
Did it?
Lawler will tie up Lawler with the advantage side headlock. Not for long, though. And Lawler holding on to the ropes. And look at the King strut there. Jerry the King Lawler with a little strut there.
And a little disrespect, if you ask me.
Oh, that's disrespect. Flair knocked a one knee with a hard slap. That'll loosen your feelings. Ironic that Flair grows up in AWA territory in Minneapolis, but Lawler becomes AWA champion, beating the late Kurt Hennig. He even beat Kerry Von Erich for the world class title.
How many times do you think these two have crossed paths over the years?
You know, Lawler strutting in. About a month ago, Lawler and I were talking about Flair. You know how many times that they've wrestled?
How many times?
In their careers?
How many times?
Three.
Three times in their illustrious careers. Both these guys from coast to coast, all over the world, three times.
And never in the WWE. Oh, look at this! Lawler, this is like two guys with PhDs.
Well, now we can't say that anymore. We can't say they haven't met here in the WWE, which I love.
Hard shot there by Ric Flair, the Nature Boy.
I know for a fact that Lawler hates those chops. So Flair, keep doing it, Nate. Keep doing it, Nature Boy.
Two hard shots on the King, and of course the.
Yeah, they want to go up for a birthday.
Right hand. Lawler now step right hands, lefts and rights. And the King now. We got Memphis versus Charlotte here. And right now the Nature Boy is in trouble.
Well, it's too bad.
Break his nose, and that could be serious. Right hand by the King, and down went the Nature Boy. And Lawler. Elevating Charlotte's number one citizen with that high back body drop. And
you know, maybe it's a good thing that they haven't met a lot over the years. King didn't have a whole lot of time to prepare for this match. He psychologically just got up, said, I'm going to go change, and I'm ready to go.
Flair had to compete in the Battle Royal early, which he was eliminated by Batista. Folks, if you just joined us, we had every man in the Raw locker room was in the Battle Royal. And there's a Flair going right to work on that leg of Jerry the King Lawler. We had every man in the locker room in a battle royal, over the top rope battle royal. We had controversy in the conclusion of it. Was it Edge or was it Benoit that won it? The decision was made that Edge and Benoit would both challenge the game tonight for the world heavyweight title, a triple threat match.
Well, first of all, forgetting the most important thing. Ms. McMahon came out at the beginning of the night and said that Triple H would have to defend that world heavyweight title. He would face the winner, the one winner, not the two winners, JR. That's where Randy Orton's decision is totally unfathomable.
But Mr. McMahon also said that it was Orton's decision to make, and he did in Flair, driving the knee into the head of Jerry the King Lawler. And Lawler's up. Hammer, that leg got hammered. There's a cover by Flair. Flair and Lawler here, one-on-one here on Monday Night Raw. So still to come tonight, you've got a triple threat match for the World Heavyweight title. We've also got a World Tag Team title match.
And there's so many things that I never thought I would see, especially this match being done. This match in the ring in 2004.
Lawler pulling down the snow. And Lawler now, the right hand, knocking down Ric Flair. Flair again.
Again, the illegal right hands that we know Jerry the King Lawler is famous.
Flair on the nose and under the elbow, the reverse elbow, and the elbow drop. Lawler with a cover here and got a near fall. Lawler, a count away from beating the Nature Boy here tonight live in Baltimore.
Will certainly be a happy birthday if the King could come out with a victory. I don't think that's going to happen, but what a happy birthday that would be.
Back body drop by Jerry Lawler, and Lawler now building the offensive momentum here on the Nature Boy.
And
we've seen this before. Folks, you know what's going to happen here. Watch the right hand. Watch the right hand. And
he got him. I just thought he took way too much time. Well,
Lawler says,
this is just getting cocky.
Well, it's not enough for Ric Flair as far as Lawler is concerned. And Lawler again with that right hand right to the face. And King holding that, hurt his knee there.
I think King landed awkwardly on that right knee. That's what I'm talking about. When you go for the win, I don't care how many times you get in the ring, you need to go for the win.
Lawler hurt himself with that second fist drop on the second rope. And now Flair, the master. Flair sees an opening here. Flair sees an opening on Lawler. And Lawler, it's that cradle. It's that cradle of a near fall. Lawler got another near fall. But Lawler in trouble, and the chop block.
And the Nature Boy being very, very smart, going after that injured knee of Jerry the King Lawler.
Flair will make too many mistakes.
Lock it in.
Figure four locked in by Flair. Flair's got the figure four. Lawler's shoulders are down.
And he is nowhere near any of the ropes. This one is over when you locked in that famous figure four leg lock. Whoever would have thought we would have saw the Nature Boy defeat the King right here, live on Raw and Baltimore.
It hasn't happened yet. It hasn't happened yet. Lawler trying to turn. Lawler's trying to turn Flair over and reverse the pressure.
He's not going to get it. It's not going to happen.
Oh, Flair. Flair getting the unfair advantage using the ropes. Referee in position. That's Lawler. He wants to submit. And look at
there
Flair.
There you go.
Oh, Lawler tapped out.
There you go.
The King tapped out. Flair using the ropes.
On submission, the Nature Boy.
Ric Flair grabbed the ring ropes when it looked as if Lawler's about ready to turn Flair over to Flair's gut.
Well, it was everything we thought it was going to be, and in all honesty, then some. As a Nature Boy, very impressive. You gotta love the result.
Second out of look here. And here's the Lawler trying to turn. Lawler almost had Flair turn.
He did almost have him turn, and but it wasn't enough.
And the referee in position for Lawler's. But right, the referee didn't see the ropes. And Lawler tapped out for the figure four. Not the greatest birthday for the King, I'll tell you.
You gotta love it.
But a victory for the Nature Boy.